eyes of a little kid. And isn't that what Christmas is all about? Is us remembering what it was like when we were younger, when the world was a mystery and everything was animated and fun and magical. Well, the reindeer that you're seeing, I gotta tell you, I'm sorry, that's already sold out. I've got three choices for you from the great folks at Mr. Christmas. I've got a Santa Claus, I've got a snowman, and I've got absolutely the cutest elf, and they are climbing a ladder, and it's a ladder that's almost 4 feet tall. If you look, over their back is strapped the old C7 style light bulbs, which by the way, when we were kids, those got red hot, these stay nice and cool, but they're gonna light the Christmas tree for you. Doug Thompson, how are you, man?
Hey, I'm great, how are you?
That is so stinking cool.
Isn't this cool?
These are automatas. They're moving machines dressed up like the cutest little Christmas characters you've ever seen. That's really magical.
This is exactly what Mr. Christmas does best, better than anyone, and have been doing it for 86 years, bringing those things that we love, those nostalgic memories. Like for me as a kid, I remember going to the mall, and you would only see things like this
at the mall. Right.
In a store or in a big display setting. You could never have it at home. You could dream about it. But what Mr. Christmas does is say, you know what? Those dreams you have when you're a kid, let's make them and do them now because we have the technology
to do it. What I love is Mr. Christmas started as the company that created those big pieces for the mall display.
Exactly. So they
and
have
that was, what,
all that.
33. I missed it by a year.
They have all that experience, all that knowledge, all that working as far as making something move and making something animated. And you hit the sound button. These also play 15 Christmas songs if you would like that. If you want, you could turn them off and have them on silent. The other thing is, I have these all going to the tree, but at the back of the ladder here, there's also suction cups.
Right.
So maybe you have a front porch, a closed-in porch, or maybe you have a large window and you want to display these in a front window. You can do that, and these will go right up against that glass window.
You may not see it. There's a bar here that's attached to the ladder.
Yep.
And it goes all the way into the tree to attach to the center support. So these are very, very secure.
I'm gonna pull this
one out. Yeah, or you can put it right up against the wall, as you said. But this becomes magical to a little kid. A little kid, I'm 58. I still think it's one of the neatest things that you brought to us. This is new to us this Christmas in July.
Yes, this is something that we do. We try to come up with something that's just an out of the park, fun, animated, huge item. And this is something that you're gonna put out each year because everyone's gonna say, where are the climbers? Where's the elf that climbs the ladder? Where's the snowman that climbs the ladder?
Look at the Santa? Look at the ears on this elf. Now, by the way, we've had over 7,000 of these that have been picked up. His little pants, somebody had to make those and sew his little uniform and the little belt and the little hat and then make his little stuffed body. He climbs the ladder one step at a time. Now watch, we won't touch it. He gets to the top. I'll be honest, I have no idea how he knows he's at the top,
it's
but he
pretty
climbs
cool.
back down.
Yep, he just senses it and comes back down. And if he ever gets stuck on a branch or stuck on a bulb, you just reset him and he goes. But these pretty much just keep going. Ever since we set them up today prior to the show, they've just been
up and down,
lighting this tree. And that's what's kind of cool. If you think about it from the imagination of a child, this is what's going to be putting the lights on the tree or the lights on the display in whatever room you place them.
If you want the Santa, we're down to our final 100.
Wow. I love his face and his beard.
Yes.
Again, got a great
face. We've had thousands of these that have been ordered so far. What Mr. Christmas does is, every day of the year, their engineers, who I swear are 9-year-old children, okay? No matter how old they happen to be and, you know, chronological age, they're all 9-year-olds.
Yeah.
And they're wonderful, and they think like little kids, and they create things like this. Now, they don't do things in quote, limited editions, but they're always working. They're working on things for me for things in Christmas in July and Christmas in December for 2020.
Yes.
So what we have on this may be all we can get for the entire season.
This is it.
And I think the prices are truly very reasonable considering the impact that they make on our holiday decorating. Because you know what? I'll forget some of the Christmas ornaments on the tree. You can't forget the elf climbing the ladder to decorate it.
No. And this is almost 3.5 feet tall.
Yeah, it's 42 something inches.
And your elf is 9 inches in height, and those big bulbs
that
you talked about.
Which, by the way, is a standard size for an elf.
It's standard elf size, yeah. Consulted with Santa on that.
Standard elf size.
And the ladder, it has this heavy base at the bottom. You also get that piece so that if you want to put it into the center of the pole of the tree, you can. That way you can vary the height as far as how close you want it to the branches or if you want it to tip out a little bit.
And I like
the sack has the
I like
speaker
that it's a,
and the
a
sound.
Plug-in. So here's the sack. The speaker is actually on the bottom, but even down to the hand-wrapped twine on the bottom. And then inside is a volume control and a reset, and you plug it in. They actually took their favorite Christmas tunes and hired professional musicians.
Yes.
And even someone who did the orchestration specifically for Mr. Christmas.
Yes, they do that for all their pieces. They know how important those songs are. They know how important sound is with animation.
Right.
So they go to that extra length to get those done exclusively for their
Doug,
pieces.
People are popping in and out. You know that. They watch on Facebook.
Absolutely.
I think they're either on my Facebook page or the QVC2, and they're asking, how tall is it? So height is just over 42, almost 43 inches.
Yes.
Almost 4 feet.
Yeah.
Because you can't get a reference. People don't realize you and I are short.
I'm like 5'6 on a good day.
Yeah. I'm 5'8 because I bought those shoes out of the back of that magazine. Yeah. So these are big. These
are wonderfully
charming.
The figures are 9 inches tall. Yep.
Look at that. Just climbs up and down the ladder. We had a reindeer, and the reindeer sold out.
Yep, reindeer.
So that
gone.
One's already gone. The Santa will be the next to go. We've got less than 100, and I don't have any order on these at this point coming in for Christmas. And this is a pre-season Christmas price.
Yes. And what we like to do is get these out in advance so that everyone can start planning where they want to put them.
Yeah.
Get excited about it. Get excited for the holidays. That Santa, I keep looking at his face. It reminds me of those claymation Christmases.
Yeah,
it
yeah,
just takes you back to that time.
And I love that it's the old
C7s. Yeah. That's
dude,
great.
Dude, you get it. You understand this.
Great to see you, Dan.
As well as anybody. Doug Thompson from the folks at Mr. Christmas. We're going to take a real quick break. We're coming back. I've got 3 hours. Now I don't. Now I've got